Hey, have you ever thought about why velomobiles usually have drum brakes instead of disc brakes? Hello, I'm Saukki and welcome to the Velomobile channel. So even though most bicycles nowadays have disc brakes, which are more powerful and have better cooling than drum brakes, why velomobiles still have usually drum brakes instead of disc brakes? Surely you need much more powerful brakes on this kind of vehicle, which is much faster and much heavier than a regular bicycle. Well, let me explain. Well, first of all, I think that most of the velomobile manufacturers wants to use already available parts as much as possible, so they don't have to design and manufacture custom parts by themselves. And as far as I know, there are no readily available disc brake solutions for side-mounted wheels, like usually velomobiles and trikes have. But there's at least one manufacturer making side-mount drum brakes. So using disc brakes would mean that you probably have to design and manufacture some custom parts, or at least I guess so. But it can be done. I have seen disc brakes on some trikes. Then one other thing is that disc brake components will be all positioned outside of the wheel, while drum brakes are integrated inside the wheel hub. So disc brakes might need some more space, and there's not much extra space inside a velomobile wheel well. But I guess that it's still possible to build a velomobile with disc brakes. But if you do, then you have some more problems. I've noticed that even though I ride much less with my Azup Max compared to my velomobiles, I still have to do more maintenance to these disc brakes. I occasionally have to readjust the brake calibers like this, usually after I've took the wheel off. Well, that's pretty easy to do, it only takes something like 15 seconds. But that's only because I have very easy access to the brake calibers. But there's no easy access in velomobile wheel well, so adjusting disc brakes on a velomobile might be pain in the ass. My drum brakes actually need very little maintenance. The only adjustment I sometimes have to do is to tighten the brake wire, and that can be done here at the handlebar, so no need to reach inside the wheel well. One other thing I've noticed with the disc brakes is that the brake pads do wear out very quickly, at least if you have to ride in any weather. The water and mud flying from wheels into the brakes will wear the brake pads out very quickly. With this Azup Max I don't have to ride in bad weather because I have a velomobile for that. But with my previous bike, I did ride in rain and on wet roads, and especially the rear brake pads did wear out very quickly in wet conditions, so they required regular maintenance. There will be a lot of water and mud flying around inside the velomobile wheel well, so I would imagine that regular bicycle disc brakes in that kind of conditions would wear out very quickly. Of course, you could choose brake pads made out of material which is much harder, but then you might lose a little bit of braking power, I guess. So basically why most velomobile manufacturers use drum brakes instead of disc brakes is that these are already available parts, so they don't have to design and manufacture parts by themselves. Well, I guess they still have to modify this brake a little bit because the mounting doesn't look like same as in the drawings. Well, they have to make it fit to this custom front suspension. So you just can't make a velomobile without any custom parts. These are already designed to be mounted to a trike or a quad. Drum brakes are quite compact because the brake is integrated inside a wheel hub. Tenties need very little maintenance and adjustments. The brake pads actually last forever compared to disc brake pads because these are here protected from the elements inside the brake drum. And also removing the wheel is quite simple. There's just one bolt. So it might be quite complicated if you have this kind of velomobile with enclosed wheel wells. Drum brakes might not be as powerful as disc brakes, but because these require so much less adjustments and maintenance, these will probably perform very well in all situations, while disc brakes might suddenly lose power because brake pads are worn out after riding long periods of time in wet conditions. But then on the other hand, on mountainous area, drum brakes might overheat on long descents and then you might lose power, so you can buy custom brake drums which have some extra cooling. Or for this Quattrovelo you can mount disc brakes at the rear axle. And these rear mounted disc brakes don't have all the problems of front wheel brakes inside the wheel well. But anyway, I think that's all for this video. I hope you found this interesting. Now if I forgot something or if you have something to add, please just leave your comments into the comment section below the video. and we can have a nice conversation about brakes. But okay, please remember to subscribe to my channel if you haven't done it already. Just click the subscription button below the video and then also visit my webshop and buy something like this kind of hoodies with nice designs. But okay, thanks for watching this video and see you next time. Bye bye.